One of the positives was just the fact that we made progress. You know, like you said, we didn't come out of the win column like we would have hoped to, but the fact that we didn't take a step backwards, we moved forward, we improved in certain areas. You know, we had the girls displayed a lot of flexibility because we had to make some adjustments in the lineup, and they had great attitudes about that. They just took it on. They were willing to play wherever they needed to, so that was great to see. But I think, you know, one of my favorite positives was just to see the way that they interacted with each other, and they remained encouraging of one another. You know, sometimes when you hit the, you know, the loss column pretty hard, they start to turn on each other, and they didn't do that. They continued to work together, and not only the way that they treated each other, but the way that they treated the strangers that were around them. I mean, on our very first flight out there, there was a couple that came in and their seats were separated, and my girls gave up their seat so they could be together, you know, and just to see what great people they are.
Yeah.
That was so fun.
Yeah.
Just to watch their little kindnesses.
Yeah.
everywhere we went.
Yeah.
You know, from the breakfast room at the hotel, didn't matter.
Yeah.
I mean, they're very selfless, and that was really fun to see.
I got into volleyball from my sister because she's 2 years older than me, and so we tried a lot of sports when we were younger. She like got into volleyball, and then I was like, oh, like that's so cool, like I want to try, because like just seeing her like play and stuff, I thought it'd be something fun to do. And yeah, I've just loved it ever since. And then I'd probably say that she's my biggest influence, just because like I said, I saw her playing volleyball, and then that kind of made me want to get into it. And like, I don't know, just like the sister kind of like, you know, helping the other sister. Mm-hmm. And she would always like, if I needed help with something, she'd like kind of coach me on it, or like she'd go out with me in like the front yard and we'd like pepper together. So I did a lot, like in the summer I did like Coach McCormick's workouts that he like sent us that were like strictly volleyball. I did a lot of like lessons for volleyball, and I also just went to the gym to get some like weights in. I definitely say 2 days would help, like when we got here, just like working on that, and then just kind of getting in those extra reps whenever we don't have like games or we don't have practice. I'd probably say my favorite thing we did was go to the beach, because
yeah,
they had like these sand dunes there, and we all like climbed up the big sand dune, and then we took like these amazing pictures. And I thought it was really nice because like it was memories that we got to like share with each other, and you cannot find like a view like that in Texas, so it was really nice. I'd say my probably second favorite thing was going to Third Street, because we all kind of just got to walk around, like enjoy the day, and like we had ice cream after, which was nice.
You know, Addie's a fun player to watch. I can't recall a time that she didn't give 100%, whether it's on the court or in the classroom or serving other people or worshiping. She gives 100% all the time, and she's one that really doesn't pursue her passion, because
mm-hmm.
passions change.
Mm-hmm.
Addie passionately pursues her purpose,
mm-hmm.
and her purpose is to glorify God and to honor Christ with everything that she does.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's fun to watch her do that. That's the why behind her 100%, is
yeah,
she wants to glorify God, and so she's really fun to watch. I think there's going to be great competition.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I think. You know, right now ETBU is in first,
yeah,
and there's a six-way tie for second, which includes us. And not saying everything will stay that way, but I don't put a lot of stock in preseason polls, because you know, I know that we all have talented players,
yeah,
and I just think it's whoever, you know, works hard, and in the end, you know, if everybody competes well, then we've done well.